everyone, welcome to the Legally Yours Marketplace, and today we're here with Luke Connolly from Connolly Workplace Law to get to know Luke a little better. So thank you so much, Luke,
for joining us.
So question number one, how long have you been practicing law for?
So I've been in workplace relations for 20 years, 20 years in November.
Okay, fantastic. So, and did you start with a big firm or what sort of?
Yes, I started with Clayton Utes. Firstly, before then, I did a year with Accor Asia Pacific as their legal training officer.
Okay.
And that's where I got a taste for employment law.
Okay.
And then I applied to Clayton Utes and I was there for 10 years and moved from Sydney to open their Adelaide office, then Adelaide to Melbourne. And then I was invited to be a partner at Mills Oakley.
That's
and so I was there
background.
For starting their employment practice there for 3.5 years. And then just felt the need for, felt a bit of frustration with my clients on charging inflexibility on rates. So started my own firm.
Fantastic. And how long have you been in your own firm for?
So July 2013. So it's that just over five years, yeah.
Wonderful.
Going well.
And share with the audience a little bit about what your expertise is, obviously it's in workplace.
So yeah, it's everything to do with labour relations at the workplace. So everything from managing contractors, managing employees, HR issues, policy development. So there's the proactive and then the reactive side. So the proactive side is getting your policies and procedures right, your contract management, your bonus schemes, your share option schemes, everything to do with regulating an employee's behaviour at the workplace as well as their entitlements at the workplace. Then there's the ongoing management of employees and contractors and the issues there. OH&S is another big area of mine.
Yes, yes.
So managing those day-to-day issues, compliance issues, and then there's the reactive side, which is the unpleasant side, the disputes with employees and contractors. So industrial strikes, there may be discrimination, bullying complaints, it may go all the way to litigation with adverse action complaints or unfair dismissals. So that's the more unpleasant side, but invariably that's where it ends up a lot.
Wonderful. So would you say that your sort of expertise is going into a business, whether big, small, medium, startup, and really providing that all-encompassing service around all of those issues?
Yeah, that's right. So particularly with a startup, I'll help with compliance and setting up their business in terms of the employment contracts, the regulatory issues they need to cover, work cover, superannuation, those sort of things, insurances, helping them set up those sort of things, payroll, and then all the way to policy development and procedures, which are extremely important in this day and age with investigators coming in. It's the first thing they ask for is what are your policies and procedures to protect employees if there's been an incident, or even if you need to investigate. Investigations are very big in the workplace these days, and you must have your policies and procedures backing those things up. So,
brilliant stuff. So now tell me, what was drawing you to the legal profession way back when you decided you wanted to become a lawyer?
Yeah, I think it was. I mean, I did my law degree and I'd already done completed a first degree at a Bachelor of Business in hotel management. So I wanted to combine the two.
Okay.
So I went to Accor and then training staff. I was training in some basic employment responsibilities. And I got a taste for it. I'm like, this is enjoyable. It's quite practical and common sense, my area of law.
Yes.
And I do enjoy being with people and mixing with people and seeing outcomes. Banking and finance and stuff like that was never for me. I'm not one to sit in an office drafting all day. I like to mix with people.
Yeah, yeah.
And I find employment law, you get to do that a lot.
Yes.
So it's good.
Now, a fun question to finish the interview. So if you could have a song played every time you walk in a room, what's that song going to be?
Yes, yes. It's Kenny Rogers, The Gambler. Yeah.
Okay.
Know when to hold him, know
okay.
when to fold him, know when to walk away.
Okay. Know when to run. So is that appealing to your risk nature?
It's just my competitive edge, I suppose. I like to take the law and get the solution. I remember in my early days, I would see people that were supervising me and they'd go through the law and you'd be educated, but you'd go, well, is that really what the client wants at the end of the day? So you've got to try and, I work from the end solution. So I'll say to a client, what do you want? and then I'll work backwards to, you know, untangle the law to give them what they want. So
okay.
It's a bit of risk in that. So yeah, okay. The gambler suits me perfectly, I think.
I love it, and I love that song too. Well, thank you so much for joining
us. No
problem, Karen. If you'd like a quick match call with Luke Connolly, or you'd like a fixed fee quote for a specific legal service, head to our website, legallyyours.com.au, and you can request those services. Thanks so much for watching.